Start champion select without me, but I'm not too far behind, so it's all right. So let me just switch these back around. We are going to a game three. Haven't got to cast a game three in these best of threes in a long time, so this is exciting. Of course, Punahou did have a little bit of a connection issue in the second game, but Roosevelt was coming back, so it's hard to tell what would have actually happened. Either way, bans are going out. Roosevelt banning out Kha'Zix, Yasuo, and Gragas. And, same band as before from Punahou, Vi, Draven, and Lulu. So the Pantheon is up for Dengxi if he wants it. I don't think we'll see him going back on the Hecarim. He had a little bit of trouble with it, it looked like. Except Pantheon, Hecarim does have... He's a unique champion, I guess you could say. But, yeah, Pantheon being locked in for him. No problem. Figured that would be it. So looks like what Young J808, he did phenomenal as an early game Lee Sin, but it looked like he kind of started falling a bit behind. And of course Punahou, they had the early game advantage last game, and they were pretty dominant, but ended up giving it away a little bit by they kept getting caught out. And Young J808, like I said, his early game Lee Sin, his mechanics in general were pretty phenomenal, but like I said, ended up giving away a few kills, being in the wrong side of the jungle sometimes, and that just allowed Roosevelt to claw back into the game. And of course, then like I said, the DC happened, didn't really help out things for Punahou. Either way, I wouldn't be surprised to see him go back on that Lee Sin. Like I said, he did well, so yeah, he's gonna lock that in. Geeky Lizard gonna lock in the Thresh, take that away from Cherry Blossom. Boundless Summer, please play Urgot. Cherry Blossom, go Soraka. Just do it. Soraka, Urgot, bot lane, EG, NA. Not saying they have the best record with it, but a Poppy Urgot bot lane, let's face it. I mean, they just dominate everything. I mean, okay, well, either way. Boundless Summer switching over to Lucian for a third time tonight. Very happy with that Lucian. Hasn't been picked away from him, so he's going to keep playing it. Cherry Blossom, going to lock in Ziggs for Explosion. Let's see what Teos and Iceland. Therefore, I am pick here. Iceland, therefore I am, he has a very solid laning phase so far against Chinsek. He's been able to trump him during laning phase the entire series so far. And even his Aatrox going a little bit further and actually just dominating the top lane and attracting a lot of Roosevelt tension over there. We'll see what he picks this time around. I'm going to shrink that down a little bit. That's bothering me. Not too important, but either way. So Aatrox being hovered over again from Iceland, therefore I am. They, like I said, had a phenomenal game the first game. It was pretty amazing. He's did quite a number onto Chinsek and the entirety of Roosevelt as the Aatrox. Looks like he may be going over to it again. Teos hovering over the Nidalee for Worst Smiter NA. So we are going to be seeing some Nidalee spears in this game. That's always exciting. Of course, there are a couple of dodges coming out from Roosevelt as the Satchel Charge and the Relentless Pursuit from Boundless Summer, Cherry Blossom, Boundless Summer, respectively. Well, I should say Explosion and Boundless Summer, respectively. It makes it a little bit easier to dodge spears, but we'll see how it works out. Explosion hovering over the Leona. Shades of the first game. This is very similar to the first game in general for Roosevelt. The only difference being Chinsek right now is going to go try to might be going to Jax, try to counter the auto attack centric Aatrox on Iceland. Therefore I am, or Iceland for I for therefore I am on Aatrox, rather. Yeah, he does lock in the Jax. Explosion locks in Leona for Cherry Blossom. So, I mean, that will be shades of the first game. As far as bot lane and jungle goes, Dengxi on Pantheon, Boundless Summer, and Cherry Blossom on Lucian and Leona, respectively. Oh, Worst Smiter NA hovering over a Varus. That would be an interesting pickup. I do like Varus. There he is, locked in. He is a utility ADC, does have Chains of Corruption, has a potential to lock down an entire team, also has a slow to him as well. But with that being said, he has a lot of damage potential mid to late game. His Blighted Quivers do percent health magic damage, which is not something you find on an ADC that often. So, he can start to chunk down a lot of the a lot of the high health champions on the enemy team. With that being said, though, not really too much high health champion's gonna be seen on Roosevelt. I still feel like he is gonna have a lot of great synergy with a Nidalee, though. They both have quite a long poke. Of course, Nidalee, once she lands a spear, it's going to be huge. But then you also have the piercing arrows just kind of poke down as well. And it looks like Punahou, for the third time in a row, going to have a role swap. Young J808, who was mid lane first game, going to stay on the jungle from his second game. Going to transition over to third game on jungle as well. Geeky Lizard has been playing support this entire time. Actually going to go to Marksman, while we're Smiter NA, who's kind of been all over the place, been jungle first, mid lane second, and now going to go to support with the Thresh. And Teos going to transfer over to the mid lane, from being Marksman this entire time for Punahou. So it's going to be interesting to see how the bot lane synergy can work together with Worst Smiter NA and Geeky Lizard this time around. Not to mention the role swap. They haven't been playing this. I mean, Geeky Lizard, for instance, he hasn't been CSing this entire night. And now he's playing on an ADC whose main goal is to CS and survive. So we'll see how it works out. 2 minutes in, I'm going to give my voice a rest. I've been eating a lot of sugar and salt tonight because I'm stupid. And it hasn't been doing my voice too well. But I'm still going to be good for this game. No worries. Easy peasy. I could probably go another game if I needed to. But I don't think I'm going to. This is the best of three. The third game in a best of three. Punahou versus Roosevelt. They are 1-1 right now, which is why we're at a best of three. I'm going to mute my mic, put on some music, and I'll be back with you in a moment.
Crap!
That is a beautiful song. Song too, either way. We are in the rift once more tonight for the third time, actually. I'm just gonna mess up all my icons because I'm very uncoordinated, apparently. Actually, there you go. Good job. Let me see here. So we have yet to see a real solid jungle invade. It looks like we might see one. There's a lot of defensive positioning on the blue for the blue buff of Punahou. I don't think they're gonna go invade anything. And it looks like Roosevelt's just gonna take their defensive stances as well. So I don't think I'm gonna see any sort of jungle invade tonight, which is surprising. I usually see some sort of jungle invade. I guess technically I did see it, but not really much happening from it. So, where's Smiter NA? Looking like he is having a little bit of trouble again. He doesn't have any trinket. Still sitting in the fountain. And, I don't know, that's unfortunate because this is the final game in the best of three to go on to the finals. Punahou still has a chance. If Roosevelt or Punahou lose this, as it is, this is game number three, so this is winner take all at this point. Winner would go on to the finals, I should say. Not winner take all, that's a stupid term. Feck is. Either way, the losing team of this match does go down to the loser bracket to face the winner of Iolani and McKinley. And that will be determined later on in the week. But for now, this is the game to go to the finals, to have a guaranteed spot in the finals. So we'll see how it goes. Where Smiter NA is back, got that trinket, no problem, easy peasy. Picked up a Doran shield as well. So Boundless Summer said he's been having quite the time. Oh, that's Arctic Ops! Arctic Ops Varus. First time I've seen the skin in-game, I'm very excited. Either way, so Chinsek, he's gonna have a little bit more of a dueling presence in the top lane against the Aatrox. And there's a Zenith Blade on the bot lane, where Smiter NA does flay her back, but not in time to deny the Zenith Blade. And there's a lot of damage going on to Boundless Summer from Geeky Lizard. Where Smiter NA got the hook onto Cherry Blossom, not much to follow it up there. There's a Zenith Blade just missing, just out of range. Excuse me. On to Geeky Lizard. This is going to be a little bit confusing again for me because, like I said, I've been used to calling Geeky Lizard in the support role two games in a row. And there's an early game gank onto. Actually, I guess it's about 3 minutes. Not really that early, but either way. Gank going on to top lane's Chinsek from YoungJ808. as one of the strongest points he had last game was that Young J808. He knew where to be in every lane. He made his presence felt extremely hard. And he really helped out his Punahou's laning phase. So he's going to try to replicate that. He's going to go back up top lane. There's a flash from Chinsek. He does jump over to the Warden, dodges the Sonic Coconut, and that's going to leave Young J808 to just roam back around to another side of the jungle. With that being said, though, Ignite goes down on Chinsek. First Blood may be coming out from... Oh my god, no! The First Blood actually might be going to Dinxie here. He does have his flash up. He might be trying to flash for a spear. There it is. He did get the First Blood from the crit on the Heartseeker Strike. Meanwhile, in the bot lane, Geeky Lizard being taken down quite low, but it's going to be retaliated. And then coming back again, reciprocated by Boundless Summer with a Piercing Light. Geeky Lizard still has his barrier up. Chinsek still in that top lane. Looks like they might be trying to pick up a kill. Reset the red buff on Dinxie. Yeah, Chinsek barely survived the ignite in the top lane. Wise enough to chug health pots as his life bar was ticking down. Just a little bit of a misplay from top lane Punahou, but I mean, you can't blame him. He clearly looked like he was going to get the kill, but it was just a little bit off. The counter strike really helping out Chinsek in the top lane. Either way, Gamers focus on bot lane though. And for good reason, Piercing Light extending all the way back to Geeky Lizard. And Explosion has Teus shoved all the way into the turret. And Boundless Summer standing on a ward. I don't think he really cares though. So yeah, Doran Shield starts from both supports in the bot lane. Doran's shield actually being started for Chinsek in the top lane. Meanwhile, oh, there's actually a Thresh especially ridden by Young J808. And Boundless Summer going to try to make the best of this, get a kill onto Geeky Lizard. He does not get it though. Worst Smiter NA picking a kill onto Boundless Summer. Now Cherry Blossom being slowed by the Tempest, forced to flash. Flash being reciprocated by Young J808. Let's see if they can pick up a kill here. They do get it with the Resonating Strike. Young J808 picking up another kill. Meanwhile, Explosion getting the best of Teus in the mid lane. Almost falling himself, but got that barrier. Used the barrier to deny the Ignite kill from Teus. And that's actually interesting, seeing an Ignite on Nidalee. Usually Nidalees are known for just standing back spearing. Ignite only being used for laning phase as far as the Nidalee is concerned, but whenever come time for after laning phase, when you go to siege the lanes, it's more useful to have a barrier. I decided to take a knife for a little bit more lane dominance, but unfortunately right now, in that case, not really paying off. Kill going over to Explosion, leading in CS as well. But a tier being picked up by Teus. Gonna try to get a little bit of a mid-game spike with those spears. See the levels charges it into the Seraph's Embrace. Oh yeah, not much happening right now. There is Spider kill going up in top lane. There was a kill going over Dinxie, but an assist going over to Chinsek. Still down in CS. Nice Ice Slam, therefore I am. Pretty many can be a solid laner with the CS. With the CS advantage he has up there. So Explosion gonna just bully Teus out of lane. Doing a great job on Ziggs. Like I said, Ziggs is a huge comfort pick for Explosion. He knows him very well. He's played him quite a bit throughout the tournament. But either way, Counter-Strike gonna lock down Iceland there for him. But they're all coming out. And the Ignite gonna take him out. He still has Blood Pool up, or Blood Well, whatever. I think it's Blood Well. But it's not gonna matter, because he's gonna just completely lifesteal that back up. Either way, Young J808 being caught at his own jungle, jungling blue, and Dinxie gonna lock him down for Boundless Summer to pick up the kill. And Boundless, actually, Dinxie did pick up the blue buff there as well. Mandrop coming down in the bot lane. He He's there by himself, but he's going to lock down Geeky Lizard. Nah, he's not. He's going to ride Thresh Express right out. So I feel like that was a little bit premature on the man drop. He could have waited for Cherry Blossom to get down there for a little bit of extra CC to lock down Geeky Lizard. Now Cherry Blossom, or Balanced Summoner, to pick up another kill. But either way, with Young J808 being driven back to his base, and they're going to pick up a possibly pick up an early game dragon here. 8-minute, 52-second dragon. There's no wards in the favor of Punahou right now. So that is the first dragon going over to him. Young J808 going to be caught out. Xenoblade and locked down by Dinksy. Cherry Blossom does pick up the kill onto that one. It's pretty easy peasy for him. And that pink ward is going to see the ward over the wall. Right next to the wall, I should say. Looks like Dinksy is going to make his way to the bot lane. Solar Flare is not up. Cherry Blossom's not even level 6, I should say. Yeah, Taos, look at that. Taos getting half, almost half health with an auto attack. That was a buffed auto attack from Zigzo. And the bouncing bomb. That's a lot of damage coming out. Does have Chalice of Harmony right now. No AP coming out from that. But started with the Doran's Ring. Either way, there goes Chains of Corruption going out onto Dinksy and Cherry Blossom. Just going to lock him down. And Dinksy actually getting caught, brought into the walls. Worst Smiter in A, picking up a kill there. Exhaust goes down on Geeky Lizard. Looks like Balanced Summer maybe picking up a kill onto that one. Light Slinger going to give him that one. Double kill going over to Worst Smiter in A, actually. He might actually pick up a triple kill here. Barrier being popped. But there's the Mega Inferno Bomb. Worst Smiter in A actually picks up a kill. Gets a Rampage out of that. 401. He does a technical triple kill, even though it wasn't recognized. Worst Smiter in A doing some work. Of course, it was Roosevelt who did dive that, and there's Counter-Strike down. That allows Iceland, therefore I am, to go right in on a Chinsek, get quite a bit of damage, chunking him down. And Young J808 gonna steal his steal Dinksy's blue buff in retaliation for his blue buff being stolen. Oh, and I think Young J actually walked outside of the bush. Excuse me. Oh, looks like we might be seeing a tower dive here. Chinsek does flash out. I slam, therefore I am flashing back out in return. Dinksy does have his man drop up. Might not have to use it, though. Yeah, he's just going to go back. Not going to use it. Young J808 just going to walk out of there with this blue, with Dinksy's blue buff in tow. Young J808 is actually losing out quite a bit of farm with how much he's roaming into lane, staying there, not really getting too much out of it, and getting caught in his own jungle, apparently. He gets kicked right through the wall, thinks he does, by Young J808's Dragon Rage. So Teus, not really much in the way of mana here, and actually gets flashed and stunned by Dinksy's Pantheon. That's going to be a dead mid lead. Meanwhile, in the bot lane, there's Solar Flare followed by following the Zenith Blade in the bot lane. Flash and Relentless Pursuit from Balanced Summer going to pick up a kill onto Geeky Lizard. And there's a lot of damage coming out onto Worst Smiter NA. And the Culling not going to be enough to pick up a kill in the bot lane. But meanwhile, in the mid lane, first tower does go over to Roosevelt. Now in the top lane, though, Bilgewater Cutlass for Bilgewater Cutlass. Chinsek not getting the best of that one, though. I feel like Iceland, therefore I am, could have went in on that even harder. It does have Ignite up. I decided not to. Just going to shove Chinsek out. 59 CS and 90 in that top lane. But, I mean, with the way the rest of Roosevelt's playing right now, it might not matter because Roosevelt's getting the objective control right now. If you can get the first dragon and the first two turrets of the game so far, not to mention Dixie, been pretty effective in his gank so far. And even driving Young J808 out of his own jungle a little bit. Dragon's going to be up in about 2 minutes. Punahou getting their first turret of the game in the through the top lane. And it looks like Iceland, therefore I am, going to look to do exactly what he did in the first game and just stay in that top lane and be a total nuisance. Just completely drive Chinsek out of this game for Roosevelt. And there's two pink wards being picked up. That's 60 gold for Young J808. That's actually quite a bit. Oh, piercing arrow does find its mark. On to Boundless Summer. He's just going to lifesteal that back up. He does have Bloodthirster at 13 minutes already. And two Doran's Blades. It's quite a bit to go to help him heal back up. A lot of pink wards going down already in this game, which I do like the pink ward coverage. It does show a lot of experience with the wards there. Either way, blue going to go over to Teos. Throwing those spears a little bit more and have the cooldown on his abilities, like the heal, which is going to be very helpful to him. And a Death Sentence landed onto Balanced Summer. That's going to allow Young J808 to come out, but he actually gets kicked out with a Knight was on War Smiter in a. He does get the kill onto that one. Explosion, though, being taken down by Geeky Lizard as well, and there's a Death Sentence landing back onto Cherry Blossom. Where Smiter NA, he's doing some very freaking baller work on the Thresh play right now. Five oh and three has a Talisman Ascension built right now. Dragon's gonna be up in about 7 seconds. I don't think Punahou has the timer on it. So yeah, it is up, but they do have a ward down there, I believe. Check it out. No, they actually don't. They have a ward over here. I don't think it's going to be able to see Dragon. No, they have no vision on Dragon, so therefore no timer on Dragon. They don't know it's up right now. Which is why it's not being contested for right at the moment. Either way. Looks like a little bit of a ward battle going on. I do like that. And another pink being run into. People finally understand that they need to walk into that bush because there's a ward there. There's always a pink ward there. And I slam out there. For I am just going to terrorize Chinsek even more in the top lane. He actually has Blade of the Ruin King already, but either way, Young J808, not gonna let Chinsek get away, and there's Ignite going down as well as the, that was actually Blade of the Ruin King going on to Young J808. Either way, the Dragon actually goes over to Roosevelt, the Culling coming out as well, Teo's having to flash out of the way. That's one thing about being Cougar form, is you can't get out pretty fast, but inner top lane turret gonna go down in favor of Punahou. So it's 2 turrets to 2 right now. But the blue side of Roosevelt is in control of Punahou right now, as they have very little vision right now. And there's Change of Corruption landing onto Cherry Blossom. Dinksie gonna be running away here. The Talisman Ascension is popped. Spear does land. Let's see if anything else lands. There's a Flash Flake coming out, and Geeky Lizard picks up the kill onto that one. Another hook coming out the box just a little bit too late. Relentless Pursuit got Balanced Summer out of there. So yeah, this where's Smiter NA? I'm almost thinking he probably should have been a support this entire time in all three games so far, because he is doing some work right now on Thresh, and that's going to allow Punahou to pick up the third turret of the game, the mid turret this time, and that gives the entire blue side of the jungle over to Punahou right now. The minions are going to be pushing more in toward Roosevelt, I should say. Chinsek making his way over, going to try to battle UK808. And actually might be venturing here. Counter-Strike, not going to hit the stun radius. UK808 just going to back off, though. Blade of the Ruin King being completed for I Slam, therefore I am. More single target damage, going a similar build as the first game, and there is no reason not to. Did great the first game on Aatrox, repeating that success. Here comes Thresh Express from Teos. I Slam, therefore I am, diving in hard. He's going to have his well procced, but Balanced Summer getting hooked. Not much there to follow it up, though. Although Young J808 does get in there, and Dragon Rage kicks Balanced Summer to death. I Slam, therefore I am, does actually get out, playing Cherry Blossom back. Where Smiter NA does, allowing Teos to pick up a kill onto that one. Punahou's got the team fight here. they're doing some great team fighting synergy. There's some team fight work here, picking apart Roosevelt one by one. And Chinsek did get the top lane turret. I mean, what cost? That might be an inner mid lane turret going down in favor of Punahou, but there is no minions on their side. But Dixie gets hooked, flayed, and killed by Worst Smiter NA. That's a dominating Thresh. He's almost legendary. He needs two more kills to be a legendary Thresh. That's incredible. But either way, Chinsek, I don't think he wants to be a part of this. He actually does dodge the hook. Thank goodness for him. Cherry Blossom. I don't know if he was going for the Zenith Blade onto a Worst Smiter NA, but it's probably best that he didn't hit that. Blue buff being picked up by Teos. So yeah, approaching 20 minutes right now. It's 7 kills to 15. And this is what happened last game. Punahou took control of the kill lead, I should say, by quite a bit. I mean, right now they're double the kills. And by 20 minutes, they actually, like I said, they had control of the game. They ended up giving it away. They were a little too arrogant in their move, not respecting Roosevelt's power. And ended up kind of giving the game away, even before Worst Smiter NA disconnected. Had Worst Smiter NA been there, I mean, Punahou had all the chance in the world to come back. But, I mean, they were losing the game. I mean, little by little. Away, and that's one of the reasons why we do find ourselves here in the third game. Let's see if Roosevelt can secure a victory to go on to the finals in this game, or if Punahou can repeat the success from their first game, secure their own spot in the finals. And as I've said it before, no matter who loses here, they do have a chance to meet back up in the finals as the loser bracket. Let's get back to that later. Mandrop coming in along with the Radius. See all the circles coming out. Mega Inferno Bob and Mandrop going to come out, and that's going to zone out Worst Smiter NA. Chains of Corruption going to go down. But either way, Explosion picks up the shutdown on Worst Smiter NA. No Legendary Thresh this game. That's all that's picked up so far. Young J 808, again, back in a bad position. But look at the split push. I slam, therefore I am. They're trying to get out. They're trying to back. But the rest of Punahou not letting them back. This is incredible. This is awesome strategy from Punahou right now. Young J 808, give it his life for it, but it might be either his life or an inhibitor. I slam, therefore I am. Has it halfway down. Nobody's back yet. There are no... What? What just happened? Did I disconnect? I hope I didn't disconnect. No, my connection's still here. I don't know if League just crashed. Explosion happened there. Blue inhibitor goes down. I slam, therefore I am. I did get the inhibitor. Not sure what happened. A little bit of lag. Either way, Dixie in a bad situation here. Might be finding himself in hell. There he goes. Geeky Lizard picking up the kill into that one. Chinsek getting hooked. I slam, therefore I am. Picking up a kill on Balance Summer as well. Double kill going over Geeky Lizard onto Chinsek. Oh my gosh, so that's what happens when explosions happen. A lot of explosion happens in one area, goes into another one. That Talisman Ascension being popped there. Punahou's looking for a Baron, I believe. They're throwing down traps. They got a pink ward over. They have vision. They have the vision control. There's no vision on Baron from Roosevelt right now. So they have, I'm pretty sure this is going to be a free Baron. It's going down a little bit slow, but nobody's in the vicinity. There's a Mega Inferno Bomb only going to help them out, though. The Baron does go over to Punahou. Alright, so, Inhibitor, like I said, Super Minions pushing into that top wave, into Roosevelt's base. Ah, look at that! That was so cool! Arctic Ops, he grapples upward. That's awesome. Either way, as I was saying, Super Minions pushing into Roosevelt's base, or at least trying to get there. So that's keeping Roosevelt focused on that top lane right now. Either way, Dragon is up. That is something that Roosevelt can secure. have been doing a good job securing the dragons. The Baron buffs are on Punahou right now, so if they choose to engage this, it'll be 5v5 with a good source of power onto Punahou. Tiamat being completed for I Slam, Therefore I Am. Cherry Blossom being slowed by Young 808. And this is an easy turret to be picked up. There he goes. He's going to get it. Cherry Blossom going to be slowed by Blades of Torment. Oh, that was a fantastic Solar Flare, but not going to be enough to save Cherry Blossom or Boundless Summer. And Chinsek going to be hooked and killed by Worst Smiter in A. And it looks like they might just be tanking up this turret themselves. Ice Slam, Therefore I Am, taking up quite a bit of the damage here. Did get the Kale's Crucible thrown onto him to get a little bit more health. My Worst Smiter in A. And meanwhile, though, Super Minions are pushing into the base over here. They're going to be sieging onto the first Nexus turret. Or at least the top Nexus turret, I should say. Meanwhile, inner bot lane turret, that's going to go down in favor of Punahou. They have complete control of this map, complete control of this game. The Barons are still on all members of Punahou right now. And Balanced Summer actually disconnects. This is tournament draft, so they can pause, buddy. Connects right back instantly. Nexus turret goes down, and Balanced Summer cannot focus on the bot lane. That is their power. Man drop coming out, and the inhibitor is still up. Nobody got the inhibitor. Punahou needs the inhibitor. They got it finally. So bot and top inhibitor going down, and Punahou are dropping like flies right now. Ice Slam, Therefore I Am, getting a double kill over to Explosion. But damage done. Two turrets down. Actually, that was three in that entire run, technically. And an inhibitor. That bot lane just got wrecked by Punahou. And the top lane inhibitor is still down as well. So there's going to be a big wave of super minions coming in to Roosevelt's base pretty soon. It's going to be up soon. So that's a little bit of an interesting build coming out from YoungJ808, but I mean his team is doing pretty well. I guess he wants to just have that little bit extra of a damage, that last whisper right now. Meanwhile, Geeky Lizard, I mean, it's working out for him. Has an Affinity Edge and Blade of the Ruin King, which is rather interesting. But either way, with this Nidalee and Varus on Punahou, we're going to see some pretty decent siege coming out. They're going to have to be dodging hooks. They're going to be dodging spears. They're going to be dodging arrows. So this is pretty hard to contest. There's Solar Flare laying on three members, and they actually just grouped for all the damage to come out to him. Teos does fall. Worst Smiter NA on the run as well. YoungJ808 was able to take out Cherry Blossom, and then Worst Smiter NA going to get a... give a double kill. Actually, no, it was Chinsek giving a double kill over to YoungJ808, following the hook by Worst Smiter MA, but at a Dark Flight not working out in the favor of Ice Slam, Therefore I Am. Either way, Dixie jumping onto Geeky Lizard, and Explosion gets pick up a kill onto that one. He is still alive. He is still full health. He's looking for possibly a quadra kill. Shutdown going over to him, and there's a flash coming out from Worst Smiter NA. Flash followed by Explosion. Hook being landed. It's just going to delay the inevitable, I believe. There's a lot of power coming out from Worst Smiter NA, but another double kill coming out from Explosion. Man, he is trying to carry Roosevelt back into this game. Inhibitor still down for Roosevelt in the bot lane. I don't even think they got the mid lane turret. No, they didn't. It's only half health. They were sieging quite a bit, but then they grouped for a Man Drop and Mega Inferno Bomb after Cherry Blossom threw down the Solar Flare. So this is the type of team that you cannot group against. Roosevelt has a lot of AoE damage coming out from them between... I mean, pretty much everyone on their team has AoE damage, actually, even Chinsek. So you cannot... I mean, yeah, you cannot couple... You cannot group for the synergistic ults and damage of Roosevelt right now. So Baron's going to be up in a minute. Dragon going to be up in a minute as well. gonna see some dancing around the pits here. Let's see which one what pit they choose though. It looks like Dinksy might be getting caught out here. He's just a hook away from death, and he does get landed onto him, but Young J808 kicks him back into Teos. And this is a full-on engage right now. Young J808 does fall. Chains of Corruption went down. Not really going to stop anybody. Boundless Summer taking advantage. Does take out three Geeky Lizard. Ice Land there for him. Doing quite a number. Gets a double kill out of it. But it's 2-for-3 right now. And he's not going to survive Explosion's massive damage burst that he has. And Teos did make his way out of there. And these fights are not going in the favor of Punahou right now. And Roosevelt slowly making their way back into this game. It's 49.8k to 51k. So roughly 1,000 gold spread. 22 kills to 26 and 4 turrets to 7. Svelte's making their way back into this one. Both of their inhibitors are up right now. Punahou keeps trying to focus on that mid lane inner turret. Not sure, I mean, there's with inhibitors up, it'd be wise for them to go for one of those. And Cherry Blossom walking right by the bush that has a pink ward in it, naturally, like most people do. I swear, I thought last game was indication that everyone's learning from that, but apparently not. It's not happening. Talisman Ascension being popped by Cherry Blossom to get out of the way of Young J808's Dragon Rage kick back into Teos. Teos doesn't really have too much power behind him, honestly. He has a Rabadon's Death Cap, but that's about it. I don't think that tier is really working out for him right now. Is that 750? Needs to upgrade to the Archangel Staff, but has the components for his Zhonya's. So it's rather interesting for them. Either way, Punahou going to try to secure this dragon. Meanwhile, it's like Roosevelt may be swinging top lane, or to the Baron. And yeah, that's going to force Punahou to back off and make their way up to Baron as well. So Talisman Ascension being popped. Going to see a little bit of a dance here. And no hooks, no way piercing arrows, nothing landed. Thresh Express being ridden across the wall. Or over the wall, I should say. Through the wall, technically. Or Young J808. I'm just going to clear out wards here. So game kind of coming to a standstill. Both teams know what's on the line here. Spot, a guaranteed spot in the finals. Just trying to play this one carefully. Not making too many rash decisions, as rash decisions have already been made here. Been costing both teams some kills and leads and objectives. Looks like Punahou going to go back to their poking game, although Teos is backing off, leaving only Geeky Lizard to be the ones poking. Looks like they're going to try to secure the dragon, get themselves a little bit of gold in the game here. Should be almost down. It's going down relatively slow. Last Whisper being completed on Geeky Lizard, so he has 3 big items right now. Gonna be piercing through the armor of Dinksy, who's building more armor than normal. Both top laners, of course, going very, very single target damage, as most top laners do whenever they're fighters. Blade of the Rune King, Ravenous Hydra, being on Ice Slam, Therefore I Am, while Blade of the Rune King and Trinity Force are very standard on Jax, being completed in the top lane for Chinsek, or being completed for Chinsek, because they're not even in top lane anymore. Talisman Ascension being popped by Cherry Blossom, only hits one person with the Solar Flare, the Calling, not doing too much either. That was two wasted ults, but there's Chains of Corruption by Geeky Lizard. He's almost out of position, but flashes back. Dinksy does pick up a kill on Therefore I Am. Teos reciprocating with Cherry Blossom, but Ballast Summer taking out Geeky Lizard, and that's the big amount of damage down for Punahou right now. 2-for-1 in this fight. Roosevelt's going to back off and just kind of play it easy. Wait for their minion wave to get here. Maybe siege the turret a little bit. There's a lot of power on Ballast Summer. Between that, between the Bloodthirster Triforce and Last Whisper, he still has 2 Dornish Blades as well. There's going to be a lot of damage going out onto the turret, and that is going to be an inner mid lane or inhibitor mid lane turret going down in favor of Roosevelt. Safe to say, they are back in this one, no problem. Oh, Deus running right into a bomb. Quite a bit of damage done to him. So now Punahou has to make some thinking to do right now. Not really sure what they're wanting to do. Although they are focusing on the Baron, and in fact they're engaging on the Baron. There's no vision, no vision on the Baron from Roosevelt, and actually Chinsek just left it. Roosevelt are making their way up there. The Baron's not going down too fast here. Man drop coming in. Solar Flare as well as Mega Inferno Bomb. And actually, the Baron does go over to Punahou. Let's see if it's going to be enough, though. The double kill coming out from Explosion. But, oh man, Sly Slam, therefore I am. Doing a number on everyone there, but it's not going to be enough. Shutdown does go over to him, though. Oh, and the Nidalee Trap going to kill Boundless Summer. So it is 4-for-3 right now. Teos, the only one left. So much burst AoE ultimate damage coming out from Roosevelt, and that pretty much saved them despite losing the Baron. Either way, Chinsek making his way into the Punahou base. He is ripe for turret sieging. He has Trinity Force. He has a ton of attack speed on him, and he's just gonna ignore Teos right now. And pop his ult. He may be trying to finish this here. I don't know if he can. He's going to jump across. He's going to get hooked, though, and that probably be the death of him. Teos does pick up a kill onto that one. But damage done. Nexus turret's down. So that's an exposed Nexus for Roosevelt to take prey on. And they decide to shove into this one. Bottom lane is shoving in favor of Roosevelt. And Dixie just going to secure it, possibly pick up the turret here. Actually, no, he's going to let it go. But the minions are going to be enough to take it out. And actually, it looks like that both bottom and top inner lane turrets do go down. Almost simultaneously. Baron is down. Dragon going to be up in about a minute 50. This is a seesaw matchup right now. Seesaw game. Punahou losing out on these team fights, though. They don't have a very team fight oriented team, like comp, I guess you could say. We're Smiter NA, their only tanky one on the team. I mean, there is Randuin's on YoungJ808, but it's not helping them out too much, especially against Explosion, who's doing quite the number to the health bars of Punahou. Meanwhile, Roosevelt has a huge teamfight comp, and it's been proving them very helpful in this mid-game transitioning into late game now. Been able to take out pretty much wombo combo the health bars down of Punahou. And they are sieging into this base, and the Nexus has a big giant spot on it, but a spear onto Boundless Summer. It's not going to do a huge amount of damage. He can lifesteal back up, possibly. Hook does miss, but he's not going to lifesteal off that one. Two spears do land onto Boundless Summer. He actually walks into two traps and has to get the Mikkel's Crucible onto him as well as the Locket of Iron Solari. Yeah, I got it. A lot wasted on the Valen Summer, at least a lot used. And there's a flash onto the Guardian Angeled Iceland, therefore I am, but he gets taken down quickly. Cherry Blossom lands a spectacular Solar Flare, and Iceland, therefore I am, going down without a casualty on Roosevelt right now, and this is not boding well for Punahou. And he's going to kick Dixie away, YoungJ808 is, but he's going to get Zenithbladed down. Geeky Lizard does take out Chinsek, but Explosion. Going to get a kill right there. It's 2-for-2 right now. Geeky Lizard with a double kill. Boundless Summer not very healthy with the health bars. Explosion, though, very healthy with the health bars, I should say. There's a Chains of Corruption going down on Boundless Summer, and he gets taken out by Teos, and a double kill going over Teos, and a triple spear going over Teos. And Punahou is alive another for just to live another day and fight another time. Oh my god. And the minions are shoving into their base on top and bottom for Punahou. This is not good. 15 seconds until Chinsek is up. I think it might be a downed inhibitor at this point. There's a pretty big wave, and there's nothing really to stop them at this point. The They're going to go right onto the mid lane turret. Inner mid lane turret down. It is 9-8 in favor of Roosevelt, but they are down 3k in gold. But I don't even think it's a huge issue right now. That bot lane inhibitor almost going down. Dixie is up. Does have his man drop. They need to be careful. Punahou does. The top lane inhibitor. More likely going to be saved here. Nice slam there for IM. Going to be able to take out the dragon here. Baron should be up pretty soon. So Banshee's Veil being completed onto Ballast Summer. Going to help him survive a little bit of the onslaught. Especially if I slam there for IM. Going to knock up everyone. He's not going to be able to knock up Ballast Summer. And that's going to be huge for him, because he needs to dish out as much damage as possible. He has a Bloodthirster, Trinity Force, and Last Whisper. He has a lot of power behind him. Just needs to make sure he can dish it out. And if he's knocked up, he cannot do that. Or if he's hooked. So Banshee's Veil, good pickup. The Guardian Angels, is that back on? Oh, he just went back. Guardian Angel is not on, not up, I should say, for... Oh yeah, it's right there. I slam, therefore I am. But there are two other Guardian Angels coming out onto Geeky Lizard and Teos. So a lot of... You're going to have to repeat some kills every on these team fights for Roosevelt. You have to kill Teos and Geeky Lizard twice. Of course, Geeky Lizard also has a Banshee's Veil. I'm just going to play the Siege here, but Talisman Ascension being popped, and Solar Flare not hitting anybody, but thinks he does catch his Ice Slam. Therefore, I am Bloodwell being popped up here, but it's not going to help him out. Dinksy picks up the kill onto that one. Meanwhile, though, Geeky Lizard getting a kill, but Jinsek going to reciprocate it 2-for-1 right now. Explosion pretty much by himself, and the Chains of Corruption actually misses, and that's going to allow Jinsek to just get right in the mix of everything. Geeky Lizard going down, almost killing Explosion beforehand. Actually gets a shutdown on that one. So it is 3-for-2 right now. Hook not finding its mark. Ballast Summer going to do a number onto the health bars of Teos and Worst Smiter in A. There's a spear. Oh, this hook did not land. I don't think it would have done anything, though. So there's only Teos left. The inhibitor is... the mid lane inhibitor is up. So they gotta be dodging some spears. They can go in onto this Nexus. They don't have Lich Bane on Explosion, but they do have the Triforce. And here it comes. Roosevelt's going for the Nexus. They're gonna get it. Teos cannot stop him. Game number 3 does go over to Roosevelt, and they advance onto the finals. Oh my gosh. 41 minute game. 74k to 75k. There was 35 kills to 38 kills. That was a close game. Punahou almost bringing it back. After having it in the early game, they've had two very strong laning phases in a row, but they've lacked the teamfight synergy, lacked the teamfight comp, and that cost them in the end. Congratulations to Roosevelt for going to the third game, bringing it to the third game, actually, and going on to the finals. So with that being said, Punahou does move down to the loser bracket, and they will face the winner of McKinley versus Iulani. Either way, that's it for me tonight. My name is Joshua Fekes Quest. It's good casting for you, and I'll see you folks later. Have a good night.